Hello friends, in this module we will be discussing the searching the literature using the online databases part of your MOOC. And as the name sounds, the databases are the driving force of the economy these days, and they are the latest storehouse of the information, and getting the information from these databases would be a very good activity for the researcher. So we are discussing more about it. So web search is perhaps the most widely used fruitful activity of the internet, and it's surfing for a researcher is a very, very good and productive cause. You would all agree with this, that most of the times we spend our time on the internet in the web surfing and web searching for some information. The real skill of a researcher thus resides in the art of asking from a database of knowledge. So according to the definition of the database directive, database shall mean a collection of the independent works, data or other material arranged in a systematic or methodical way and individually accessible by the electronic or other means. Now this is a very comprehensive definition, and it encompasses all the necessary elements, like the database should be accessible through electronic means as well as non-electronic means, and all our database efforts should correspond to this kind of definition. The famous management guru, as we all know, Peter Drucker, once said that the past leaders very well knew how to tell, but the future leaders should know how to ask. It is very important to ask, as I explained in the earlier slide. Even the biggest things fail to answer you when you don't ask in a right way. So searching the web is in a novel way to ask the database by using the digital method of query is a very, very important skill, which is a must for the digital researcher. And we will use the word digital method in this module of database interaction. And digital methods, they have been described as a term that seek to capture a recent development in the internet related research, summarized as approach to the web as a data set. And if you can read between the lines of this definition, it makes very clear that digital methods treat whole of the web as a complete data set, rather than focusing on any particular database. So in fact, we are talking about the big data here, and for this module's purpose, our big data set is referred to as the whole of the internet and its websites. Hence, the digital methods of database inquiry include not only the web-based data from subject-specific databases, while also including social media platform data like Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram. So, in order to specify further, this data on the social network platforms is a crowdsourced data. It's a very, very rich data. So, our database definition will include that also. And we must know that the modern world is driven by the data, and data is, eulogized as the new oil of the economy. So, it should be taken in a very, very serious manner, because the data is characterized by the parameters of volume, velocity, information, type, and authentication. Data is regarded as the most sacrosanct and formative element of any research study, as we all know. But this data is quickly changing its form and the nature. And now the soft copy of the things is more important rather than the hard copy of the information. So we should have some basic skills in order to deal with this soft copy, soft form of the data. A data, as we all know, is a plural term, and datum is a singular one. So it is regarded as a scientifically recorded factual piece of information which can be appropriated for further analysis. And by this sentence we mean that the data should be accessible in a format that is amenable to the scientific and statistical analysis. So the database must be having an independent entity, that is the information units, which must be arranged in a unique methodological and systematic way. Finally, they must be machine readable, standardized and accessible to the users. So this paragraph says that any random piece of information collected using the random search method, it's not the database, right? And it should be machine readable, standardized and accessible to all the users, independent of the platforms, independent of the bandwidth. So according to Hugenholt, individual accessibility implies that a user should be able to find every single item in the database. Otherwise, the database can only obtain protection on the part of items that can actually be found. So in this case, the individual accessibility is very, very important. So Hugenholt describes two kind of accessibility. One, the database should be accessible technically to the users, and second, the user should have the basic digital literacy skill in order to access this database. So let's see a few data moments around the world, and then we will quickly jump to the practical part of it. Because data moments are very, very important right now. There are two kind of data moments, the free data and the open data. They look similar terms, but they are quite different one. Free data, it is free to use with a few restrictions like non-commercial use and by giving credit, etc. That is free. I mean, you can use it the way you like. You can modify it, you can redistribute it, you can rephrase it, rehash it. You have full freedom with that. And there are some inherent clause the data which can be which the data can be used as. So it is free basically. But the open data movement, as the name implies, openly distributable for all purposes like remixing and onward distribution of the improved database. Yeah, again, there are some restrictions that you can modify it, but you have to keep a certain elements of the data as such, and the same is written in the data privacy policy. So open data is an information that is accessible to everyone, machine readable, offered online at zero cost, and has no limits on reuse and redistributions. So sometimes you will feel that free data and open data, they are more or less the same thing, but free data is really the free one, and open data may have a certain kind of restriction subject to the field and the place. So what are the standard techniques to interact with the database? So all databases are active and dynamic websites, but all the websites are not databases. So this is very deep sentence, that all the websites, they are not the database, whereas all the databases are, they are strictly active and they are dynamic. It means they keep on updating. So once established as a website, the database is amenable to all searching queries of the Boolean search, like site name, then the query word, and the word, and the word, or the word, entitle the word. And for example, you have seen the Google power searching commands, and it is mentioned here also in the example part, like site dot colon papers dot ssrn and so on and so forth. It means all the databases, they are essentially websites. So all the Google power searching commands which were discussed in the effective googling, they are applicable to the databases also. And it is shown as the pictorial representation of the Google power search, and we will discuss it more in the practical part of it. Social Science Research Network, this is a very good database for the social science researcher. It provides the facility of searching through search terms in title, abstract and keywords. Keywords are also known as tags, and full text by author's name and against a defined time frame. So we will discuss more it in the practical part of it, where we will display this in the video format. So most of the databases provide this facility in order to maximize the user's search experience. Right now there are many databases which may not be so much researcher friendly, but ultimately they have to evolve and they have to conform to the user expectations. So one more such exhaustive open database is available at data.worldbank.org. This is the very good website and the database also, but it is mostly suited for the economics and commerce discipline, because it gives you open databases on various countries on different parameters across the world, and for the last 20-30 years you can compare, download the data freely, and you know, run your own analysis. And a comprehensive list of free academic databases is available on Wikipedia also. You can go that and go and see that. There will be agreements, different agreements on the database, like what facility it offers, whether it is free or not, whether it is paid, and all that kind of stuff. One approach of database accessibility positions the internet as a huge big database in itself, which includes all the academic publishers' websites, Google Books, different projects, etc. Whereas another approach employs the accessibility of the specialized database on diverse subjects. Both of these approaches, they are apparently similar, but they are diametrically different, because every research discipline has a different database of its own now, and it is very hard to encompass all the databases into one. So it is better if we go as per the subject. So while interacting with the database, there are two type of errors which we are prone to. First is the type 1 error, to see the relationship between two variables when there is none. It is strictly a statistical term, but applying this principle to the databases, it simply means that just by entering the data in a non-scientific way in Google would artificially jack up the results. That is, just entering the words like research methods in social sciences without double quotes would give you so many inflated results. This is also known as false positive. So just on a lighter note, if you enter something in the Google, just like research methods in social sciences, so it will show the results in millions, right? Because it will search research differently, methodology differently, indifferently, and social science differently, and combine all the results and jack up the results. But you know that these results are not the right results for you. So this is type 1 error, and this is also known as false positive. In type 2 error, there is a relationship, but we are not able to see it. That is, in the search terms, just entering query in the Google may result in the first few results highly relevant ones because of the artificial intelligence applications in search. Sometimes you enter random terms in the Google, and Google gives you good results on the very first 100 results. But we are not able to see it because we are accustomed to a formatted thinking. But I tell you that Google is applying artificial intelligence applications in the search in a big way, and it senses your search, it senses your behavior as per the past history of your Google search and gives you the results, so which are most likely the relevant ones. But when we fail to appreciate the quality of result when it is present there actually. So this is known as type 2 error. Both these errors, they can be corrected by using the Google Power searching commands. We come back to the Google Books, which is a relatively unexplored area for the researchers, because most of the researchers, they know that yeah, something of this sort exist on the Google server, but we mostly don't employ that. Google has a very good collection of all the latest as well as the old books on books.google.com. This is a Google Books library project, which is aimed at scanning and making searchable the collection of several major research libraries. Even the latest books are available on it, free of cost. Free of cost means the partial access to the publication, partial access to the pages. So if you open the Google Books and enter your query, then it will show the relevant results in the selected format. But you will see that the book is not displayed in its entirety and few pages are grayed out. They will not be present. So that is the part of the agreement. But as far as free version is concerned, you will find so many citations, so many references even in the free pages also, which are available on the books. So along with the bibliographic information, snippets of text from the books are also available. We will discuss more in the application part, but researchers spend their creative energy in conforming to a particular style of referencing, just arranging the references in nice text and then manually searching through them to put them into the alphabetical order. All this kind of chaos is removed when you access the Google Books. And short snippets, snippet means a small, short information regarding your data query. And that is available and that is sufficient in many cases as the review of literature. So that can be accessed too. Unlike the databases, whenever query is entered in the Google Books, it is shown as highlighted and the researcher can only fix his or her attention on the selected instance. This is very, very important because when you interact with any database, then database give the results as per your own query, but they don't always highlight the particular word or the query item which was searched. So it is very, very easy in the Google and it is highlighted in the yellow. So you focus your attention in the whole book only on the selected word. So its context can be copied, sentence can be copied and citation is ready for you. So this way information overload is averted. So you are not the victim of information overload anymore, which is many a times not in case of databases which supply the information is bulk. Information for being useful must be structured, as you know, it should be organized and contextualized and relevant along with being relational. So all these information parameters should be fulfilled when we interact with the database. It should be structured, organized, contextualized, it should have a relation, it should be relevant for you. So Google has inbuilt AI functions, artificial intelligence functions, and some of the functions you have to learn from your own depending upon the Google power searching commands. And very soon you will be able to establish the context of it and relation of it. So internet being the graveyard of big data is widely depicted as the information boon, whereas in reality, this unstructured and non-contextual data poses huge challenge. As we all know that just talking about the internet and praising it that it has got a huge collection of the information, it is normally a risky job for the researchers because most of the data is unstructured and we don't possess all the necessary skills in order to contextualize and use it. So a very productive and easy function to use Google Advanced Book Search is present in the gear. We will discuss it in the practical portion, and it is in the extreme right corner of the page and it solves most of your advanced research queries.
Now we come to the practical aspect of the data extraction from the databases. As discussed in theory, there are a few databases like SSRN, that is Social Science Research Network. So if you open the database and go to the advanced search, so it gives you the facility of search through the title abstract and the keywords and the full text and through author and through the different time frames. and then you can run the search here. But these advanced search terms, they differ from database to database, and not all the database may be having this kind of advanced search. So it is always advisable to learn the Google Power searching commands first, because all the databases are websites, and Google searching commands, they are applicable on any website. So if you select the command of site colon database name and look for the paper which are having the word media in the title and the corpus word in the text. This is standard Google Power Search command discussed in the effective Googling module. So it will come out with 38 results in total. Like corpus informed appraisal analysis of Thai media representation. Let me tell you that even the advanced search command on the database will not give you this much precise result, because it doesn't have any facility of giving you the particular word in title and simultaneously the particular word in the text. So it is always advisable to learn it, and all you have to just do is just change the name of the website here, that is the name of the database, and rest of the commands, they are the same. Similarly, you can access the World Bank website for the documents on media, and it is showing only 10 results, and many of the results are not relevant, like media queries, media contact, etc. But the World Bank site doesn't have much literature on the media part of the research. Then we open the Google Scholar. Google Scholar is a free database. It is widely popular among researchers for many reasons. So if you want to search for the term corpus method and technology and file type is PDF, so it gives you 162 results. These are the standard Google Power searching commands, and they are applicable across the board on all Google products. So it gives many things, like this article is cited by 113 people, and you can go to the related articles also. And if you want to see the reference, then it has given you the ready-made references in 506 manual style. So ours is APA. You can copy this and paste, plus you can download in BibTeX and Knot and other software, reference management softwares. So it is relatively easy, and it gives you time frame on the left side. And you can create the alert also. Like I can create the alert of this search query. In the future, if any document is uploaded on the Google Scholar database which has the word corpus method and technology in the PDF format, then a mail would come to me with these many results, and I will be able to open it. So rather than you searching the database, the data is now alerting you on the publications. You can further go to my library, matrices, etc., different settings. These are the standard commands on the database. then we go to Google Books. As I have explained in the theory part, that Google Books is relatively less popular among the researchers despite its huge database of the books. So I am going to enter the same query here, corpus method and technology and communication research and press enter. Be showing 678 results, and if I click any one of the links, then the whole book open. The only rider is that you cannot open all the pages, and it will grayed out a few pages. But the free part is also very good, and you can gain much from the free part. Like, it is showing that 28 to 29 are not the part of this preview. So around 20 or 30% of the book portion is available to you. And if you want to search inside this book now, then you should click here and search for the word corpus and press go. So here it will give you the summary of all the pages where the corpus word is used in this book. And instead of reading page to page, you just read your specific context here. Let me share with you that you cannot download this text because it is in the image file format, and for that you have to download another software, that is googlebooksdownloader.com. So once it opens, then you can download this and you can enter the book's URL here and start. So it will download the PDF format for you, and that will be a text format, and you can copy the sentence from there. So this was a very good example of the database, and on the top of it, it is free to access, and you can use it as per your own choice. And there are many other tools also, like advanced book search. If you click on this, then you will get whole set of options, and you can choose as per your own requirement.
Finally, in the first case, researchers are trained to use the advanced research skills and its various combination and permutations, because this is the most crucial skill for a researcher in order to access the database. A few tools regarding the data scraping may also be need to be learned here. Second is the most improved search algorithms coupled with artificial intelligence applications based on the user search behavior. So this the second thing is not in our hands, because we are the users of the technology, we are not the developers. But the database access skills will always depend on these two criteria, that is updated skill set of the researcher as well as the artificial intelligence application of the databases which provide the data to the researcher. Thank you so much.